See here, we have learned, we have proved angle side angle congruency rule. If two angles and one included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the included side of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent, which is already we have proved. Therefore, in the first example here, in triangles PQR and triangle MN, LMN, we have two angles and one included side. Included side means for these two angles, this is a side in between the given two angles. Therefore, this side is called included side. Therefore, two angles on included side is given. Here also two angles on included side is given. Therefore, from angle side angle congruency rule, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, we can write it as triangle PQR is a congruent to triangle LMN. Right? Because from ASA congruency rule, two angles and one included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and included side. Are equal to the corresponding two angles and included side. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent triangles. See, in this example, we have two angles are equal, but the included side, this side is not an included side. Therefore, in a triangle, what is the sum of angles in a triangle? The sum of angles in a triangle is 180. Therefore, this angle must be 60 degrees. Therefore, this angle also 60 degrees. For this reason only, angle side angle congruency rule will also apply for angle angle side congruency rule, also side angle angle congruency rule. Because the sum of angles in a triangle is 180, this side need not to be included side. Therefore, this side may be included side or may not be included side. The angle side angle congruency rule applies. That means ASA congruency rule applies and AAS congruency rule also holds. Like that, SAS congruency rule also applies. But whereas SAS congruency rule, angle must be included angle. Other than include angle, for example, SAS congruency rule holds, but not SSA, ASS congruency not holds. Whereas ASA congruency rule holds, also AAS also holds and SAA also holds. These three are congruency rules holds, but whereas SAS congruency rule, the angle must be included angle. See here, we have already known SAS congruency rule and ASA congruency rule. ASA congruency rule means AAS congruency rule also holds and SAA congruency rule also holds. So here, from the above two congruency rules, we have to solve some examples given in the textbook. For example, example 1, in the given figure, here is a given figure. In the given figure, AB and CD are intersecting at O. So this is AB and this is CD. These two are intersecting at O. And OA equal to OB. This is OA equal to OB. And OD is equal to OC. OD equal to OC. Here we can clearly see that two triangles are there. The two triangles are triangle AOD and triangle BOC. We have to check in these two triangles, is there any three conditions are satisfied? Any three means these three are satisfied, SAS congruency rule or AAS congruency rule. See once, we have in this example, in this figure, we have two triangles. The two triangles are, what are the two triangles? In triangle AOD, triangle AOD and triangle BOC. Triangle AOD and BOC, we have AO equal to BO, already given, OA equal to OB is given. Also, OD equal to OC. OD equal to OC. In this triangle OD equal to in this triangle OC. Also, what do you know about these two angles? These two angles are vertically opposite angles. These two angles are vertically opposite angles. That means angle AOD equal to angle BOC. Because these two angles are vertically opposite angles, these two angles are equal. These two are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Therefore, these two angles are equal. See here in triangle AOD and BOC, two sides, AO and OD, this is included angle. For AO and OD, this angle is included angle. Two sides and included angle of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two sides and included angle of the other triangle. Therefore, given two triangles are congruent. By SAS congruence rule, by SAS congruence axiom, we have triangle AOD is congruent to triangle BOC. If triangle AOD is congruent to triangle BOC, we have already learned that six equalities are old good. Three equalities are given here. What are the third remaining three equalities? What are the remaining three equalities? There are AO, BO already given, OD and OC already given. Also, AD by CPCT, the six equalities are called as corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Therefore, the other three equalities are AD equal to BC, AD equal to BC, and what are the remaining two angles? AD is equal to BC, and the other remaining angles are angle OAD equal to angle OAD equal to angle OBC. Angle OAD equal to angle OBC, because angle A equal to angle B. Angle OBC. Since these two angles are, these two angles are alternate angles for, these two angles are alternate angles for AD and BC. Angle OAD and OBC are alternate interior angles for AD and BC, and these two angles are equal. When alternate interior angles are equal, then the two lines are parallel. Therefore, AD is a parallel to BC. We have right here only two equalities. What is the third equality? Angle at D equal to angle at C also. Angle at D equal to angle at C is also. Therefore, if two triangles are congruent, then all six equalities are hold good. Three are already given. Other three are, we have to write them. See here, we have to solve second example 2 also. See here what is given in example 2. AB is a line segment and the line L is a perpendicular bisector, and L is a perpendicular bisector of AB. If a point P lies on L, show that P is equidistant from A and B. If a point P lies on L, show that P is equidistant from A and B. What is required to prove here? P is equidistant from A and B. That means P is PA equal to PB. We have to show PA equal to PB. What will be required to prove here? PA equal to PB. Right. For this, we have to solution. From the figure we have, what we have? Two triangles are there. What are two triangles? Triangle ABC and triangle BPC. Because L is perpendicular bisector of AB, since L is perpendicular bisector of AB, perpendicular bisector of AB, angle PCA equal to angle PCA is equal to angle PCB equal to 90 degrees, because it is a perpendicular bisector of AB. Angle PCA equal to angle PCB equal to 90 degrees. Also AC equal to CB. AC equal to BC. Also AC equal to BC. In these two triangles, PC is the common side. In these two triangles, PC is the common side. PC equal to PC. This is common side. Right. Since L is perpendicular bisector of AB, because if L is perpendicular bisector of AB, this angle must be 90 degrees. When this angle 90 degrees, this angle also 90 degrees. Therefore, angle PCA equal to 90, angle PCB is also 90 degrees. Also, it is perpendicular bisector. Bisector means it bisects AB into two equal parts. That means AC equal to BC. Also, BC is the common side. In triangles, ACP and triangle BCP, we have triangle ACP and BCP. We have AC equal to BC and PC equal to PC, and angle at C equal to angle at C. Therefore, we have to write by SAS congruence rule. By SAS congruence rule, we have to write triangle ACP is a congruent to triangle BCP. Once again, we have to check this order. AC equal to BC, correct, and CP equal to CP, that is common side. And what is given? Angle at C equal to angle at C, right? Therefore, this order is correct. Therefore, triangle ACP is congruent to triangle BCP. Triangle ACP is congruent to triangle BCP. Then, what we have to prove here? PA equal to PB. So, from this, we have three equalities are given here. What are the other three equalities? AC equal to BC and CP is the common side. What is the third side here? PA equal to PB. Therefore, P is equidistant from A and B. P is equidistant from A and B. From these examples, you have to practice two examples which is given in do this page number 153. Do this, you have to solve the two questions with the help of these examples. Also the given two congruency rules. Now we have to solve example 3. See example 3 here. In a given figure, AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC. Then show that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. What is the given figure here? This is the given figure. In this figure, we have two triangles. The first triangle is triangle ABC and the second triangle is triangle CDA. These two triangles. We compare these two triangles. In the given two triangles, what is given here? AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC. AB is parallel to DC. So, AB is parallel to DC. Solution, we have to go through the solution. Since AB is parallel to DC, AB is parallel to DC, these two angles, this angle and this, that means angle CAB, angle CAB, that means angle at A in the angle ABC, in triangle ABC, angle at A in a triangle ABC, angle CAB is equal to angle CAB is equal to angle ACD, angle ACD, right? What are these two angles? Alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Therefore, alternate interior angles. Therefore, these two angles are equal because AB is parallel to DC. Alternate interior angles are equal. Therefore, angle at A equal to angle at C. Also, what is given here? AD is parallel to BC is given. AD is parallel to BC is given. AD is parallel to BC. Since AD is parallel to BC, since AD is parallel to BC, see here, AD is parallel to BC, this angle and this angle. These two angles are alternate interior angles for AD and BC. Therefore, angle BCA is equal to angle BCA is equal to angle CAD. Angle BCA is equal to angle CAD. These two angles are also alternate interior angles for AD and BC. These alternate interior angles for AB and BC. For AB and BC. Right. Therefore, these two angles are also equal. Also, in these two triangles, AC is the common side. AC is the common side. Therefore, AC equal to AC. See here, what is given in these two triangles? In this triangle, two angles, one included side, are equal to the two angles and one included side of the other triangle. Therefore, these two triangles are, by ASA congruency rule, these two triangles are congruent triangles. That means, triangle ABC, that means, by ASA congruency rule, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABC is congruent to, write the order, angle at A equal to angle at C, therefore angle C B means D, angle C D A. Therefore triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. Therefore triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. Hence we prove. Right. See here. See example 4 in the textbook. In the figure, AL is parallel to DC. AL is parallel to DC, and E is the midpoint of BC. E is the midpoint of BC. Since E is the midpoint of BC, B is equal to C. E is the midpoint of BC. B equal to C. Show that triangle EBL is congruent to triangle ECB. So, for solution, consider these two triangles, triangle EBL and triangle ECB. Triangle EBL and ECB. In triangle EBL and ECB, these two angles are vertically opposite angles. See here, these two angles are vertically opposite angles. Also, given that AL is parallel to DC. Since AL is parallel to DC, these two angles, this angle and this angle, these two angles are alternate interior angles. These two angles are alternate interior angles for AL and DC. Therefore, these two angles are also equal. For these two angles, this is the included side. These two angles, this is the included side. By ASA congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent triangles. Therefore, see here, consider triangle EBL and ECD. Angle BL equal to angle CED, because these two angles are vertically opposite angles. Also, B is equal to CE. Why B is equal to CE? Since E is the midpoint of BC, B equal to CE. Also, angle EBL equal to angle ECD. Why angle EBL equal to angle ECD? These two angles are alternate interior angles for AL and DC. Therefore, the alternate interior angles are also equal. From this, by ASA congruence rule, triangle EBL is congruent to triangle ECD. See here, in exercise 7.1, second question, see once here what is given in that question. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD equal to BC. What is given? AD equal to BC. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD equal to BC, and angle DAB, angle DAB equal to angle CBA. Angle BAB equal to angle CBA, then prove that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC and BD equal to EC. The third one is angle ABD equal to angle BAC. We can divide this quadrilateral into two parts like this: triangle ABD, triangle ABD, and triangle ABC. Like this, we can divide these two triangles as like this. This is one triangle and this is another triangle. See here, what is given? AD is equal to BC. AD equal to BC is already given. Solution: already we have in triangles ABD and triangle BAC. ABD and BAC we have. What do we have? AD equal to BC. AD equal to BC, which is given in the question. AD equal to BC. And see here, AB is the common side for two triangles. AB is the common side for two triangles. This is common side for two triangles. ABD also and BAC also. For two triangles, this is a common side. AB equal to AB. Common side. Also, what is given here? Angle BAB equal to angle DAB equal to DAB is here. Angle DAB is equal to DAB is equal to angle DAB is equal to angle ABC. Angle CBA. Angle CBA. This is also given. See here, for the given two sides, this angle is included angle. Given two sides, this angle is included angle. Therefore, these two triangles are, by SAS congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent. By SAS congruence rule, triangle ABD and triangle BAC are congruent. Therefore, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. Once again, check the order. Compulsory. AB, AB, common side. And AD, BC, AD, BC. Also, what is given? Angle at A equal to angle at B. Therefore, this is correct order. Therefore, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. Now, three equalities are here. What are the other three equalities? By CPCT, what are the other three equalities? Two sides already given. What is the third side here? AD and AB is given. What is the third side? BD and AC. Therefore, BD equal to AC. BD equal to AC. One angle is given. What is the other two angles? Angle at B equal to angle at B equal to angle at A. What is angle at B here? Angle at B, angle ABD. Angle ABD. ABD equal to equal to, okay, angle at B is equal to angle at A. What is angle at A? Angle BAC. Angle BAC. Hands full. See, BD equal to EC, AC and angle ABD equal to angle BAC. Write down. See children, in exercise 7.1, see fifth question. What is given in fifth question here? In the adjacent figure, AC equal to AE. AC equal to AE. Here is AC and it is AE. AC equal to AE and AB equal to AD. AB equal to AD and angle BAD. This is angle BAD. Angle BAD equal to angle EAC. Angle BAD equal to angle EAC. These three conditions are given. What are the three conditions here? AC equal to AE, AB equal to AD, and angle BAD equal to angle EAC. Then show that BC equal to DE. BC equal to DE. This is BC and this is DE. BC equal to DE. Show that BC equal to DE. See here, how many triangles are there? See, in the triangles, we have to take two triangles. What are two triangles? Triangle ABC and triangle ADE. We have to take triangle ABC and triangle ADE. Since these two triangles have two sides and one angle, two sides and one angle, we have to prove by SAS congruency rule these two triangles are congruent. See here, in triangle ABC, this is triangle ABC, right? This is triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, angle BAC equal to angle BAC, this is
is the angle BAC. BAC equal to the sum of these two angles is BAC. What is the angle here? Angle BAD plus angle BAC. So angle BAC equal to angle BAD plus angle BAC. This is angle BAD and this is angle BAC. So sum of these two equal to angle BAC. Also, what is given here? Angle BAD equal to angle EAC. So we have to write angle BAD as angle EAC, because angle BAD equal to angle EAC, which is already given. Therefore, angle BAD equal to angle EAC plus angle BAC. What is see here from the figure? What we have? Angle EAC plus angle BAC means angle EAD or angle DAE. So angle BAC equal to angle EAD, BAC equal to angle EAD. In triangles ABC and ADE, see here, compare these two triangles ABC and ADE. These two triangles, see here, in ABC triangle, side AB and side AC are equal to the corresponding two sides of triangle AD. See here, AB and AC are equal to the corresponding sides AD and AE. Also, the included angle which is in between the two sides, given two sides, that is angle BAC is equal to angle EAD or angle DAE. See here, in triangle ABC and triangle ADE, AC equal to AE and AB equal to AD already given. The angle, this is included angle, angle BAC equal to angle EAD, which is proved here. Angle BAC equal to angle EAD. From these three, see here, two sides and one included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and one included angle of the other triangle. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent triangles. See, by SAS congruence rule, we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle AD. When these two triangles are congruent, all six equalities are holdable. Here, three equalities are given. Other three also holds. Therefore, side BC, already two sides are equal. So what is the third side here? Third side is side BC equal to side DE. Therefore, BC equal to DE, which we have to prove BC equal to DE. Hence, proof. See children, exercise 7.1, sixth problem. What is given in sixth problem? In right angle triangle ABC, right angle is at C. This is right angle triangle ABC. In this triangle, right angle is at C. In right angle triangle ABC, right angle is at C. M is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB. See here, M is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB. So, BM equal to AM. BM equal to AM, since M is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB. Right? C is joined to M and produced to D such that DM equal to CM. That means CM equal to DM. Point D is joined to B, then show that triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. We have to prove first one. First one is triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. Compare these two triangles. Triangle AMC is here and triangle BMD is here. Triangle AMC is we have to show triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. In these two triangles, what we know? We know that AM equal to BM. We know that in triangles
AMC and BMB, we know what we know, AM equal to BM and CM equal to DM. CM equal to DM. Right. Next. What do you know about these two angles? These two angles are vertically opposite angles. These two angles are vertically opposite angles. That means angle AMC. Angle AMC equal to angle BMD. These two angles are vertically opposite angles. Since these two are vertically opposite angles, these two angles are equal. AM equal to BM, this is given, this is also given, and AMC equal to BMD, these two angles are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. See here, in this triangle, two sides and one included angle of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two sides and included angle of the other triangle. Therefore, by SAS congruency rule, these two triangles are congruent. That means, by SAS congruency rule, we have triangle AMC is congruent to triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. Right. When two triangles are congruent, all six conditions are, all six equalities are holding. Already three equalities are here. Remaining three equalities are also holds. What are the remaining three equalities? By CBCD, we can write two sides already given. What is the third side here? AM and CM is given. AC equal to BD. The third side is AC equal to BD. This is, say, A. This AC equal to BD. AC equal to BD. Also, what will we know? Angle AMC equal to angle BMD. Angle at A equal to, in this, from this result, angle at A equal to angle at B. What is angle at A? Angle MAC. Angle MAC is equal to, what is angle at B? Angle MBD. Angle MBD. That means, angle MAC equal to angle MBD. That means, angle BAC, angle BAC equal to angle MBD means, MBD means, angle MBD means angle ABD, angle ABD, angle ABD. That means these two angles are alternate interior angles per alternate interior angles per which lines? These two angles are alternate interior angles per AC and BD. AC and BD, so that AC is parallel to BD. AC is parallel to BD. From B we have AC is parallel to BD. AC is parallel to BD. Since AC parallel to BD, see these lines. AC parallel to BD, BC is a transversal. BC is a transversal. Since AC is parallel to BD, BC is a transversal. Since BC is a transversal, the angle at C and angle at B, that means angle ACB, angle ACB plus angle ACB plus angle DBC, angle DBC equal to 180 degrees. Since these two angles are co-interior angles, these two angles are co-interior angles. Co-interior angles. co-interior angles. Therefore, sum of co-interior angles equal to 180 degrees. Therefore, since angle ACB equal to 90 degrees, since given that right angle at C, in triangle ABC, right angle is at C. Therefore, angle ACB equal to 90 degrees. We have 90 plus angle DBC equal to 180 degrees. That means angle DBC equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, DBC is a right angle. Therefore, angle DBC is a right angle. We have proved second one also. This is the proof for second one. Angle DBC is a right angle. See, already first is proved, triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMB. Second one is also proved, angle DBC is a right angle. We have proved earlier. Next, we have to show that triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. For this, try to compare these two triangles, triangle DBC and triangle ABC. What is triangle DBC? This is triangle DBC and this is triangle ACB. In these two triangles, we have already proved in first solution AC equal to BD. In first solution, AC equal to BD, we have already proved from A. Also, BC is a common side for both the triangles. BC equal to BC, that is common side for both the triangles. Also, third one is angle ACB is a right angle which is given in the question. DBC is also right angle which is proved in second question. So, angle ACB equal to angle DBC. From this, side angle side is equal to the corresponding side angle side of the another triangle. Therefore, by SAS congruency rule, we have triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. From this, by CPCT, what will we have to write? We have to write by CPCT. See here, from third proof, we have triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. By CPCT, what will we have write here? CD equal to AB. Side CD equal to AB. What is meant by CD? CM plus MD. CM plus MD. That means these two are equal, which is already given. M is a and joint to M produces M such that DM equal to CM. DM and CM are equal. Therefore, CM and DM are equal. 2CM equal to AB. That means CM equal to half AB. And all 4 bits are proved. From these observations, you have to solve all questions in exercise 7.1 with the help of your teacher.